It has long been a legend within those regions that the Rashomor descendants of the fallen angels lived within the hollow mountain caverns that network across vast regions completely hidden within the network of tunnels. Legend has it that this race was a direct line of the second generation of Rashom, known in legend as the Cyclops Giants. More closely related to their Neanderthal species, the lineage that links them to the fallen angels is most apparent in their Rh-negative dominant chromosomes that are marked by their extremely red hair. The other white-haired giants would be their cousins and the third generation of Rashom, the infamous and legendary titans who long ago declared war on both their Cyclops forefathers and their matriarch generation there, Rashom themselves. They entitled them under the basic reference name of Chaos because of their war-scarred personalities due to the attempted genocide of their race during the Flood that left them prone to violent outbursts, as too were the Cyclops as they were bred tools of war. The Titans decided that if they were to be capable of building any sort of civilized society such as cities and building structures, then they would have to contain their ancestors somewhere away from the surface. Naturally, Tartarus was created to hold the children of the fallen angels and their war machine children, along with a few other problematic creatures of the war against their ancestors, such as Aphrodite, the Hecatoncheirs, Cerberus, the Manticore, and the Rashom. But when Zeus rose to adulthood to overthrow his father Cronos, he opened Tartarus to free the Cyclops to ask them for their help in overthrowing Cronus. Some of the Rashom were released, as well as Aphrodite, who was the most dangerous of them all. The Rashom, stripped of their powerful forms such as Athoth and Zatoth and other ancients of the Cthulhu mythos, they were reduced to shadow-like vapors and mist for a short time, which, at the end of the war against the Titans, Zeus agreed with their ancestors' need to be imprisoned, and so he fashioned Pandora's box to contain them. The ones that these military encountered were descendants of the Cyclops that Zeus had freed and given an island to inhabit for their aid in defeating the Titans. It was them also who fashioned the legendary weapons of the Olympians. The island they resided on was called Lachesis, or better known today as England, and home to their current descendants, the Irish and the Scottish, who I hear are still great blacksmiths today. I had to dig deep into the legends and dust off the myths to uncover the truth behind the fall of Olympus to find this out. It goes deeper than this. It seems there was a fourth generation, one between the Titans and the Olympians, that many refer to as sorcerers, the Genii. Solomon was one of them. They remained unknown because of the tightly kept secretive nature of the Arabic provinces at that time. As it turns out, by historical accounts, the children of the fallen ones dwelled in the regions north of current-day Lebanon, separated by what is called the Gate of the Amorites, a group of the Titans, also known as the Scythians, that were called the cousins, had intermingled with the Amorites and the Amalekites that gave forth the generation of Nephilim among the Arabic regions. This generation went on to create the kingdom of Ashur and ruled under the wise thumb of Yulgabanda, or Uranus, whose entitlements among others were commonly referred to as King of the Universe. He was deposed from their throne by Sargon of Akkad, Cronos, who built the kingdom of Assyria, until he was deposed by his son in a coup that had been hidden from the truth of historical records and labeled the Scorpion King. The Titanomachy, or War of the Titans, is a historical account of the rise against Sargon and the Assyrians hidden by refugees fleeing Assyria into the early Greek regions. By these accounts we see that Aphrodite was the curse of Cronos, as she was the legitimate heir to the throne Sargon had taken, as she was the last daughter of Uranus taken away from battle before the siege of Sargon took over the city. As the legends go, the fall of Olympus happened in a coup that was planned by Aphrodite, as Zeus still laid claim to what was her father's kingdom. She had called upon Hera, who was in the order of Hecate before she married Zeus, and held her to her oath and loyalty to the coven before all else, and used her to orchestrate the fall of Zeus. She had Hera convince Hades to kidnap Bestheron to draw the attention of the gods away and kill Delphi, for her foresight jeopardized Aphrodite's plan. Once that was done, she seduced Ares, the first logical choice of Zeus's fall, to orchestrate taking Zeus's throne by tying Zeus down with the chains of Tiamat, or the eternal chains that held the dragon in the bottomless pit for 1,000 years, and had Hades set loose the Hecatoncheires to aid Ares hold Zeus down while Hera dealt the killing blow. But she hesitated, and Zeus got loose just as the other gods showed up. They defeated Hera, Hades, Ares, the hundred-handed Cyclops, but not without the cost of the entire Parthenon of gods dead except Hermes, Zeus, Poseidon and Apollo. Hera, Ares and Hades were banished to the north, where Hera was cast into the bottomless pit bound with a part of the chains over the chasm's mouth. Ares was placed as guard over the prison, and Hades became known as Loki. Also, there was an argument between Apollo and Zeus, and it ended with Apollo walking away from the gods and renounced his title as the god of the sun. Hades was allowed to join in Zeus's hunt for Aphrodite at the cusp of the Dark Ages around 900 AD. This led them into the countryside of Denmark and Germany that climaxed in a huge battle between the forces of evil that had plagued the land. As by this point Hades had betrayed Zeus and ran back to join forces with Aphrodite. Together they brought forth many legions of demons reminiscent of the old Catholic legends, as Zeus and the others took up the roles of Micheal and the other archangels. Hermes became Gabriel, Apollo became the archangel San Raphael, Hades had become the archangel Uriel. This waged a centuries-long war that ended with Aphrodite's defeat and being sealed in a new prison that was sealed beneath a mound that many are lured to call Dililand. That really is hiding the prison of the once goddess of love, now cast down as the temptress of Venus, and what was once done to Medusa, turning her into the profane thing she was done to Aphrodite. This prison they had devised with the Celtic, who are descendants of the giants and very well capable craftsmen still to this day. However, Aphrodite had broke free at one point and continued her bloodline into the seat of the rising power at that time, and had a child with the King of Denmark, King Henry, before disappearing again, but never too far from the throne of England until the time of the French Revolution, when she was cast into the abyss by her own magic thanks to the killing blow delivered by Giles de Riz as she fell from her tower window and into their swirling abyss of oblivion. Hades was caught and chained to the boulder of Sisyphus with the other end of the eternal chains, and placed them over the entrance to where Hera hung. It was then that Zeus decided that from then on the knowledge and power of their lineage would no longer be passed along. For too long and too many times he had watched his kind cause nothing but destruction with their power. So he took the recorded history of their secrets, and their descendants slowly merged with the rest of the world seemingly normal through many of the secret societies across the world. The last known location of Zeus was as an old man, like he usually appears, rumored to have been the last of a once honorable druidic order. He was seen in the region of Wales, England around 1865, when a doorway into another place just opened up in a swirl of purple smoke, where a woman had appeared, and they were locked in battle with each other when the doorway closed around them and they disappeared. And he has not been seen or heard from since, until recently. I followed a few stories. One occurred last year, right when the pandemic first began. In Switzerland there was a massive freak lightning storm that struck 150 in the course of 5 minutes, and there were a few other cases of the same thing. Then it stopped, but not long after that I saw an article about a giant eagle being spotted off the Florida coast. Which is what led to me explaining to you about the role of what we call the pantheon of the gods, with a branch of guardian angels once assigned to Lucifer, to watch over Earth along with the 200 angels that were assigned under his command. Then he fell and Micheal took up his position, or Zeus. For this was the tale of Micheal, whom mankind had come to call Zeus at one point in order to keep secret the power and bring an end to the war of the gods, or a war between heaven and hell. However, in the early 19th century Aleister Crowley had broken the seals of Pandora's box in a ritual publicly performed, and without the knowledge that was taken from us, we have had virtually no resistance to the evils unleashed by the seven children of the fallen or lords of darkness. They brought about the Holocaust soon after being released, and history becomes uncertain as far as their On another note, my time has grown short and it is said that I am to die in November of a heart attack. Here recently I have begun to have heart problems that are similar to the stroke I had about 6 years ago. Using my kinetic skills, I mapped out an inner image of my heart and found that there is an abundance of tissue buildup forming along my upper aorta valves and my lower right aorta valve. That is a common trait of congestive heart failure. My fingertips are beginning to go numb of feeling occasionally as well, so as I had said, my time here grows short. But I worry not, for this is only the beginning of a much larger journey and I have much to accomplish after this life is done.